Good evening, everybody, from Cairo, Egypt. Your host is always Haysam Ali, and I am an aviation technical instructor. Welcome again to my aviation training solution. You will get short, simple, and on-the-go information and solution regarding aircraft steering system. So, number one, what about nowadays steering system? Steering system nowadays is steering by wire. Aircraft is steered by electric currents or electric inputs. There is no mechanical cable and pulleys. There is no steering by cables. So steering by wire, it is much better than the former hydromechanical one. Aircraft weight is much reduced. Aircraft or the aircraft steering system nowadays having a better integration with other aircraft systems. So for example, steering system nowadays can easily integrate with, for example, autopilot system for auto land purposes. And finally, steering system troubleshooting practices and maintenance practices are much enhanced that you can easily troubleshoot the steering system from the aircraft central maintenance system. So this is the steering system nowadays, steering by wire. Again, steering by wire. Number two, what is the architecture of the steering system, or what is the main component of the steering system? Steering system architecture or steering by wire architecture are mainly depend on a steering computer, which are continuously interpret cockpit inputs, like from steering handwheels or rudder pedals, to compute it and interpret it and generate a current to the steering servo valve, which will deliver hydraulic pressure to the nose wheels. So this current, before generated, it need to be compared with actual position of the nose wheels. This is accomplished by the rotary variable differential transducers. So from here, again, you will got the steering system architecture, which is mainly composed of a steering computer, which is always interpret cockpit inputs to compute and generate a current to the servo valve. This current, before generated, must be computed and compared with actual position of nose wheels delivered from the rotary variable differential transducers. So what is the main component of the steering system? Steering computer, cockpit inputs like steering handwheels or rudder pedals, a servo valve, and a rotary variable differential transducers. These components are sometimes suffer from a current drift due to their drift, and the aircraft suffer from what we are called abnormal veering. The captain, while taxiing the aircraft, found that the aircraft progressively drift from the runway center line or the taxiway center line. So this is what we are called an abnormal veering. The captain sometimes, or the flight crew sometimes, need to correct these drifts by putting a rudder trim value. So this rudder trim value used by the maintenance engineer to troubleshoot. According to this rudder trim correction value, you will take as a maintenance engineer a no dispatch or a maintenance action must be triggered for correcting this abnormal veering tendency. And I need to tell you that the manufacturer are always working on to enhance the steering control loop and to modify the steering control function in the avionics part of the steering system to compensate the servo valve offset or Rvdt offset or cockpit input offset. Again, the three components which may make the aircraft to drift: the servo valve, the Rvdt, and the cockpit input. And as you know, this is the main component of the steering system. So this is for today. We give a small hint regarding the steering system, its architecture, and the abnormal veering tendency or a steering problem that may happen to the aircraft. If you need to know more, there is a training session which will appear on the screen right now, which I'm calling it the aircraft veering story. You will get information regarding, or a specific information or a detailed information regarding steering system and abnormal aircraft veering. And finally, keep in mind, this is for training purposes only. It shall not supersede any official documents like aircraft maintenance manual, troubleshooting manual, and minimum equipment list. Thank you for your good listening, and I will come back so soon with another aviation training solution. Thank you for your good listening, and goodbye, my fellow pilots, aircraft maintenance engineers, and aviation safety professionals.